Hi everyone. This is Ruedi. He is one of our top solid shop floor specialists. Today, he shows you how to prepare a set of tools for a job. Our training environment offers a storage and mounting area, a tool presetter, as well as an emulated controller of a CNC machine. At the end, we will show you how the tool data and the ISO file are written to the controller. But first, Ruedi goes to the storage area. Once in storage, his first action is to log on to the terminal. Here he has access to all information, completely digital and paperless. Shop floor now shows him which tools he needs in addition to the current situation on the machine. These can be tools in storage, but also tools that still have to be assembled. But, Ruedi's first choice are tools from the complete tool storage. Checking them out is easy made with the scanner. And shop floor automatically updates the 3D visualization. For the last tool, there is no assembled instance available in storage. He therefore needs information about the required components and storage locations. For this purpose, TopSolid shop floor automatically generates a stock removal list. In addition to the stock removal list, Ruedi can see where the components are located in the 3D visualized storage. In our case, in cabinet S3, shelf 1. When the components are removed, they are also booked. This means that Ruedi removes the component and posts the number of items removed. Shop floor thus knows the current stock, the stock in circulation, and the affiliation of the components to the complete tool. Furthermore, tools and components can also be traced back across all ISO files. As soon as Ruedi has picked and booked all the components, he is ready to assemble the tool. So that he can assemble this tool correctly, TopSolid shop floor shows him the detailed drawing including the parts list. Completely digital and always up to date. Now, Ruedi assembles the tool according to the specifications as a new tool. This is then married to the virtual tool in the database, with a simple scan. Shop floor now knows which tool it is, and how it must look geometrically. Ruedi has now set up all the tools that he additionally needs on the machine. For transporting the tools to the machine, he has a trolley available. Here also, TopSolid shop floor shows a 3D visualization of the trolley. The tools are now easily booked on the trolley in automatic mode. He can choose the place completely free, while shop floor updates the storage automatically. In order to make tool information visible again, we use the so-called ESL. Information can be written to these labels over a wireless network. No actual data is currently available because the tools have not yet been measured. But we already show the tool number, comment, and machine assignment. As more data becomes available, the labels will be updated automatically. Ruedi has now completed the setup process and can start at the next station. With the tool trolley, he makes his way to the presetting. Here, he first logs on to the TopSolid shop floor terminal. All information for tool presetting is now visible and available, digital and paperless. Not only Ruedi's list of requirements but also the global tool requirements can be seen here. The color code shows the current status and the necessary actions. By selecting his specific program, he filters the list for his direct tasks. In automatic mode, Ruedi again uses the scanner to measure the tools. With the scan, the necessary measurement program is sent directly to the presetting device. At the same time, TopSolid shop floor shows the offsets to be measured in the 3D view. The measuring job then only has to be selected and executed on the presetting device. The tool is now automatically measured. If the tool is not within the defined tolerance, it must be corrected. If changes are to be made to the measuring program, these can be made directly on the presetting device. The actual tool data and also the adapted measuring program will then send back to TopSolid shop floor. This enables absolutely identical measurement of all tools without redundant data management. The actual tool data is now stored centrally in TopSolid shop floor. Since we don't have to work through complete lists, we are able to interrupt our work at any time. This means that a colleague can also measure a replacement tool in between, to keep the machine downtime as short as possible. In our example, Ru80 now measures all his tools until they are all marked green in the list. In addition to the most modern, TopSolid shop floor also supports very simple, for example, serially connected presetting devices. Ru80 has now measured all the tools and heads to the machine. In our example, this is an emulated Heidenheim TNC control with a bidirectional interface. First, Ru80 registers at the terminal. In practice, this can also be a tablet for mobile use. In the load-unload section, he now sends his ISO file to the controller. This, simply by a drag and drop. As a check, TopSolid shop floor again shows the additional tools required for this specific machine. The tools are booked into the magazine by using the barcode scanner. A fully integrated scanner is often used in production cells or automated systems. This scans the tool directly in the magazine. In our case, Ru80 now books the tools in the magazine in automatic mode with the handheld scanner. At this point, it should be mentioned that working with barcode scanners is the highest level of integration. TopSolid shop floor offers alternative ways to collaborate with older or simpler machines and to send actual data to the controller. Parallel to Ru80's upgrade, shop floor is also updating the graphic machine magazine. This not only helps the operator, but also the CAM programmers. With the help of this information, they can adjust to the current situation. This minimizes the variety of tools and setup times extremely. A quick look at the tool table shows that all tool data has been transferred. Here not only the actual data of the presetting, but also additionally required and machine-specific parameters. The necessary NC program was also sent directly to the machine. This is now activated, started, and the chips can be made. The machine is running and parts are being produced. And since everything is really as simple as shown here, Ru80 is one of our biggest fans.